At some point in our lives, we might have experienced moments of danger that awoke our adrenaline and made us feel lucky to be alive. While most of these scenarios are one-off and usually don't leave us scathing, there are some amazing stories of survival that seem impossible. Once in a while, the universe chooses people that walk away from seemingly grisly fates. Today, let's take a look at 10 unbelievable examples of people who survived impossible situations. Number 10, Vesna Volovia fell 33,000 feet from an exploding plane. Friday, January 22, 1972 was just like any other day when Vesna Volovia boarded an aircraft from Yugoslav Airlines DC-9. The plane departed from Copenhagen for Belgrade with 28 passengers and crew, but what seemed like a routine trip was turned over its head when a Croatian terrorist group planted a bomb in the cargo section. At an altitude of 33,000 feet, the bomb went off, crashing the plane into the mountains. What followed was one of the greatest survival stories of all time. Vesna Volovic, a stewardess on the plane, survived the 33,000 drop sitting on the tail of the plane. Amazingly, she was not supposed to be on that fated flight in the first place. There was a mix-up with another stewardess of the same name, which is why she was on the flight. Although she suffered a fractured skull, broken legs, and 3 broken vertebrae, one of which was crushed and left her paralyzed from her waist downwards, she was able to walk again after several operations after spending several months in and out of hospitals. Number 9, Aaron Ralston, cut off his arm to live. This man's story is a true story of a strong will to live. Pause for a minute, think about this. If you were faced with a situation of life and death, what would you be willing to do to give you a better chance of survival? Would you be willing to give out your arm or leg to stay alive? In 2003, Aaron Ralston was faced with a life and death situation. Aaron Ralston was hiking near Robber's Roost in Utah and found himself in a nearly impossible situation as he was climbing Utah's Blue John Canyon. A boulder got loose and crashed on him, pinning his hand and forearm down. He made efforts to pull free, but the stone wouldn't budge. He was pinned for 5 days beneath the rock before he understood that he had no choice but to do something drastic to save himself, unless he would die of dehydration. He made up his mind to amputate his right arm with just a multi-tool. He broke his arm bone and cut through his skin and tendons to free himself. Imagine the pain he went through. He wouldn't even be able to describe what Aaron went through cutting his arm, but he pulled through with the firm will and courage to stay alive. Number 8, Stella Maurice Rugby Team ate human flesh to survive. Some people are still terrified to travel by airplane, even though it's the safest and fastest means of transportation. And who can blame them? Plane crashes can be terrible. Even if it doesn't kill you, it can put you in a situation where survival is almost impossible. And that's exactly what happened to the Stella Maris Rugby Team. On October 12, 1972, Stella Maris Rugby Team boarded a plane to attend a rugby match. On their way, the aircraft crashed into snow-covered mountains. 17 people died instantly, but the worst wasn't over for the survivors. They were stranded on the mountainside and were forced to survive in freezing conditions with no shelter and food while waiting to be rescued. Unfortunately, the harsh conditions claimed the lives of another 10, and the remaining survivors were forced to eat the flesh of the deceased teammates to survive. After a total of 60 days, the strongest of the survivors went on a 12-day trek to get help, saving the rest of 16 out of the 45 people who boarded the plane. Before we move on, leave a like on this video, smash that subscribe button, and hit the notification bell to be the first watching new episodes. Number 7, Anatoly Brigoski survived a laser beam. The story of Anatoly Brigoski is the perfect way to highlight the incredible dangers scientists face due to equipment handling and checking daily. The Russian physicist was struck in the head by a beam from the largest Soviet particle accelerator while checking out a piece of malfunctioning equipment. The beam that struck Brigoski measured approximately 200,000 rads. For context, scientists say that 1,000 rads power is all it takes to kill anyone that comes in contact with it. So it's a miracle how Brigoski survived all that force. The beam missed his brainstem but damaged a small portion of his brain and paralyzed the left side of his face. With time, his brain began to recover, and he lost none of his intellectual capacity, and he returned to work a year and a half later. Number 6, Truman Duncan was cut into two but lived. If there's one thing you'd be pretty sure nobody could survive, it would be being cut in half. How would a half human being exist? The biology seems implausible until it happened to Truman Duncan, a railroad switchman. In 2006, he was working along the trail yards in Texas when he was swept by a moving train underneath. His lower body was so damaged that he was nearly cut into half at the waist. Somehow he was still conscious, and he called 911 himself with his cell phone. His injuries required 23 surgeries, costing him both legs and one of his kidneys, but he lived to tell the tale. Number 5, Tsutomu Yamaguchi, survived 2 atomic bombs. Wait, what? That's the reaction Tsutomu Yamaguchi got when he first recounted his story, but even as it is one of the most incredible stories that almost sounds like a lie, it did happen. Surviving the plutonium bomb, which fell on Nagasaki on August 9, 1945, is horrific enough. Tsutomu Yamaguchi survived the atomic bomb that dropped on Hiroshima 3 days earlier, before Nagasaki's bomb explosion. Coincidentally, Yamaguchi had been in Hiroshima on a business trip, and the day the bomb fell in Hiroshima was supposed to be the last day in the city. Yamaguchi was severely injured at the blast, and both his eardrums were ruptured. After the incident in Hiroshima, Yamaguchi made his way to the train station with 2 coworkers who also survived, and began the trip to his hometown of Nagasaki, where his wife and child lived. The journey took them through a landscape of shattered buildings and decayed corpses lining the streets. Many of the city's bridges had been turned and twisted wreckage, and at one river crossing, Yamaguchi was forced to swim through a layer of floating dead bodies, but he made it to Nagasaki at last. Yamaguchi was recounting his story in Nagasaki when the second bomb detonated. Miraculously, his wife and son also survived. Though he survived some effects from the radiation exposure, Yamaguchi recovered and lived until 2010. Number 4, Roy Sullivan, struck by lightning 7 times. They say lightning doesn't strike a particular place twice, but it struck a man 7 times. Virginia forest ranger Ray Sullivan had an attraction to lightning, or let's say lightning had an attraction to him. Over his 36-year career as a ranger, he was struck by lightning 7 times and survived each strike. His 7th strike earned him a place in the world records. The first lightning strike shot through Sullivan's leg in 1942, and he lost a big toenail. In 1969, a second strike made him lose eyebrows and knocked him unconscious. In 1970, another strike left his shoulder scarred. In 1972, the strike set his hair on fire. On August 7, 1973, another bolt shot through his hat and hit him on the head, set his hair on fire for the second time. A 6th strike led him with an injured ankle, but it took one lightning in 1977 to send him to the hospital with chest and stomach burns. All in all, he lived through all of his lightning encounters. Number 3, Robert Evans, survived hit by a car and train moments later. Some people believe that bad luck comes in pairs, others not so much. But whether Robert Evans belonged in the myth or not, he had his double dose of bad luck on the early morning of September 2008 when he was involved in a hit and run accident while riding a bike. For most people, that was enough trauma to last a lifetime, but fate had more in store for the 46-year-old. Walking back from the hospital, he was knocked off a narrow railway bridge by a train, surviving a second accident in 7 hours. Evans was hit by the railing of a stairway on a train. It would seem fate had more plans for Evans as he narrowly escaped being mauled over by the speeding train. Number 2, Mauro Prosperi, survived 9 days in the Sahara Desert. Mauro Prosperi, a keen endurance runner, took part in the 1994 Marathon des Sables, Marathon of the Sands, in Morocco, just like every other endurance runner who had their eyes on the prize challenging 6-day, 233-kilometer event to the Sahara Desert. Unfortunately, a nasty sandstorm occurred, causing people to be lost and ultimately causing Prosperi to lose his way. He ended up disoriented and ran in the wrong direction, ultimately running several hundred kilometers into Algeria. After running for 36 hours, he ran out of water and food. He lived off his urine and eating bats and reptiles and the occasional snake found in the desert. At some point, he attempted to commit suicide by slitting his wrists with a penknife he had with him. The attempt failed due to lack of water in his body. His blood thickened and clotted the wound. After 9 days alone in the desert, a nomadic family found him and took him to an Algerian military camp where he was taken to the hospital, where he recounted his horrifying experience. Number 1, Jose Salvador, spent 438 days in the sea. The sea is terrifying for several reasons. For one, we don't know enough about it. So far, we've only explored about a third of the water on Earth. As scary as that sounds, it gets even worse with the idea of getting lost at sea, which is why this story is one of the most incredible stories of surviving the impossible. Jose Salvador, a fisherman, drifted in the Pacific Ocean for 13 months. In a 7-meter boat after having been blown off course during a fishing trip in Mexico. He was adrift for 438 days and traveled over 6,700 miles. He said he made it through the 5,000-mile voyage by eating fish, birds, turtles, and drinking urine, rainwater, and bird blood. Somehow he made it out, and now Jose Salvador Everenga holds the record for the longest solo survival at sea. Thanks for watching. Leave the comment down below and let us know what is the craziest thing on this list. Don't forget to subscribe for new and upcoming episodes.